necessary precaution. There's been some strange things happening here in our house. So, okay. Anyway, I don't mean to make you feel anxious or alarmed. I put some salt on top of the camera, sprinkled some around me, so you should be okay. You should be safe. At least you shouldn't have anything to worry about. Not sure if you are familiar with ASMR. That's part of the reason why I'm whispering. The other part is I don't want anything or anyone to hear me. So my wife and son, they're not home right now, and of course maybe I'm just a little paranoid. Anyway, so I don't know about you, but I'm going to assume that if you're here, and thanks for tuning in, by the way, but if you're here, then you like horror movies and films as much as I do. But there are certain type of horror movies and films that I prefer and like more than others. So before we get into all of that, and in a couple minutes I'll be going over three lists of movies and films, the ones I've already seen a while ago, the ones I've recently watched about a week prior, a couple days and a week prior to the date of this video, and then a list of movies and films that I haven't seen that most likely fit into the, or are the types of movies that I like. So, I'm not really sure where to begin this video. This video idea, so to speak, came about because over the last few years, it's been very difficult for me to find the joy in things. This isn't about me, okay? So I'm not going through anything. But obviously I'm 52 now, and movies, I don't listen to music anymore. The music is dead to me. It's been that way now for like 4 or 5 years. And so the things that once used to thrill me and just captivate me when I was younger, it's harder. I don't have that same sense of awe and bewilderment and excitement. So I think it just has to do with getting older. But anyway, so my spare time, I don't really read. I don't have the patience for it. So my spare time is usually playing video games. But but I'm kind of... I'm tired of playing video games. So I want a little something more. And I haven't found, over the past year or so, I haven't really found any movies on a consistent basis, week to week. Any movies or shows really thrill me or that I enjoy. And then all of a sudden I did the video called Sitting in Silence, and under that video a few folks said it reminds them of the movie Skinamarink, if that's how you pronounce it. And I never heard of that movie. Scouts Honor, whatever. And did you hear that? You didn't hear anything? Okay. It's probably nothing. And so I just a couple days later I decided, it was a few days later. It was like a week later, I think. I just decided to take a break from playing Baldur's Gate 3, which I really like and enjoy. Decided to watch Skinamarink, and I absolutely loved it. And it has a lot of the elements that I like in movies. And then from there, that movie triggered me wanting to find more movies like it. So I did some research on the internet, and then I began to find some more movies that are, I guess you can call them, atmospheric, somewhat minimalist. Minimalist in the meaning that they're not dialogue heavy. There's not a lot of action. It almost very simple type of movies. More psychological than anything. So this recent journey started with Skinamarink, and I think I finally found and understood the types of movies that I like, but I think it all started way back with Ridley Scott's Alien from 1979. Stanley Kubrick's 2001 Space Odyssey, and the 1973 movie Silent Running. I really love that. And these movies, they do have dialogue, and they might have action sequences, but what I love about these types of movies is that the dialogue and any action sequences, they're all spaced out, and in between the dialogue and any action or jump scares, there's space. And it could be, oh, and another thing is, not a lot of music, no songs, and any music, it's also spaced out, so that in this space between the dialogue and any jump scares or action, it's just, it might be environmental sounds, just someone walking, creaking of a house, the wind, just the sound effects, the environmental, the atmosphere, so to speak. And then you have your dialogue for however long. It doesn't last long, about a minute or two. Then more space. There's like an ebb and flow. And these movies I find very relaxing, even though some of them are tense. In the case of psychological horror. But it doesn't have to be horror films. For instance, No Country for Old Men. I think it was by the Coen brothers, if I'm not mistaken. That's not a horror film. It's more of a, I don't know what you call it, drama, thriller, something like that. But that also has a lot of the elements that I like. So I'm currently in this mood or phase, however long it will last, to watch these types of movies. And as I take a break from other things that I enjoy, so who knows how long this will last. Usually I used to watch one movie a week, every couple weeks, a month. But I'm just like obsessed right now. So enough of me talking. I have my phone here and all the movies. This isn't meant to be an analysis or reviews, just casual chat, you know, about the type of movies I like, and, you know, maybe you'll like them too. I don't know how, when I first watched Eraserhead, if that was before I started this channel, or someone recommended it after, you know, on one of my videos. But I would say that David Lynch's Eraserhead was like the gateway to all these, this whole, it's not really a genre, but all these different types of films that unfortunately you never hear about in mainstream society, right? You go to the movies, what do you always see? Star Wars, a Disney movie, you know, a war movie, all these, like, I don't know how you describe them, just mainstream, safe. You will see some horror movies, but when it comes to Eraserhead or Naked Lunch, Ennis Men, a lot of these great movies that, if you ask me, deserve awards just as much as any other movie, you don't see them at the local theater, which is a shame. Anyway, so a lot of these movies I just didn't know about because I didn't know how to look for them, which is a shame. Like I said, you know, it's always Alien, another Texas Chainsaw Massacre. You know what I'm saying? But these more somewhat experimental, you know, different type of movies. Anyway, and I guess you could call these types of movies, you know, lo-fi. Some of them are analog, but I definitely don't mind the movies that have a higher production value. But I prefer the movies that are little lower budget. They don't have to be like no budget movies. And I like the movies where it's an actor you might not know about. Nothing against Nick Cage. same actor or actors in movies, and it's nice to see actors, because there's plenty of actors and they all deserve to have their time on the screen. And so it's just nice to watch a movie without seeing a particular actor and then just being reminded of other movies the whole time you're watching a movie. I think if you know what I mean. And it's also these other movies, these movies that I like, they have just people who look very plain. And I like that too. A lot of movies recently seem to have, not recently, but all throughout history of movies, people that look like models. Like, I look very attractive. And it's not like I'm jealous or anything, but I just like seeing actors that just, where they just look like regular people. That's all. There's something more realistic about that. So, okay. So I didn't mean to be here for, 15 minutes or whatever. But, so, I'm going to go over the movies I just recently saw prior to the date of this video. Then we'll go over the movies I've seen a while ago. And then a bucket list of movies I have yet to see. Alright, so I saw Skinamarink. I thought that was great. I loved everything about it. Some of the jump scare moments. Audio was quite loud. So not quite my cup of tea in that regard. But, so that's okay though. No, it's that type of movie. But I'm just very experimental, very different, unique, and that's what I love about it. I'm not going to talk too much. I'm not going to spoil anything about the plot, the movie, the ending. So if you haven't seen any of these movies, don't worry. I'm going to just kind of keep everything in a high level, just... Besides, I'm not a movie reviewer. My vocabulary is quite limited. Alright, so it started with Skinamarink. So thanks to the folks who commented on my Sitting in Silence video that mentioned that movie. Pretty much started this whole journey. Butterfly effect, so to speak. Okay, then after Skinamarink, which I loved, was Enes Men, or Enes, I'm not sure how to pronounce it, E-N-Y-S, and then Men. And by the way, all these movies will be listed in the description of this video. So that was somewhat of a folklore type of video. I think Irish or Gaelic, something around that vicinity. Scottish, Irish, whatever. So kind of a trippy movie, somewhat, but Enes Men or Enes Men. Almost the perfect type of movie that I like. No, a little bit of blood, but not, very minimal. No jump scares, I don't think, or very minimal. No, I don't think any loud sounds. Just almost a perfect movie. Love it, somewhat trippy. Of what's going on and everything, up for different interpretation, I think. And that's what I love about movies, when they don't spell everything out, kind of leave things up to your imagination. Next movie was Possum. Love it. Somewhat of a shocking revelation towards the end. Has some special effects, some practical effects, I think. I don't know if it's CGI or not, but that's a great psychological horror. I didn't even know it existed until just a couple days ago, so absolutely love it. Possum. A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night. That was the last movie that I watched. I watched that the night before, Sunday night. Absolutely great. I love that. That was recommended. Oh, and recommended by, I did a post on my channel asking, you know, reaching out for some recommendations. So I'll be getting to those. I didn't watch all of them. But, so thank you for your comments and recommendations. You're not just helping me, but anyone else passing by who happens to see that post, or anyone happens to stop by and, you know, watch this video, check out the description. But A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night, came out in 2015, and it's an Iranian vampire spaghetti western. How's that? It's black and white. It's great. There is currently an English subtitle version out right now that you can rent. The only thing I didn't like is that there are some music, some songs played throughout, but plenty of atmosphere, plenty of silence, plenty of long extended shots of one particular scene. That's what I love too. It's not every 5 seconds scene to scene to scene. It's just they'll focus like Skinamarink. They'll focus on a corner of a room for 15 seconds. Or they'll have one shot outside a factory, and they'll just stay focused on that shot while the actors slowly, you know, walk towards each other. Some dialogue, and they'll have a slow zoom. Just everything is kind of slow-paced. There's not a lot of camera movement. That's the kind of movies. They're like relaxing horror movies. I don't know how else to describe them. Yeah, so A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night. I love it, except for the music. But I find it's okay because some of the music fits the scene, what they're singing about, what the song is about, kind of fits the scene. So that's okay. Alright. Pontypool. Now, this movie doesn't really fit the minimal dialogue type of atmospheric horror that I like. But it's still a great movie. I recommend it anyway. It's dialogue heavy. Like, just dialogue mostly throughout the entire movie. Which is fine. That's the type of movie that it is. But still a unique take on the zombie apocalypse. So very, very different. And I liked it. But just doesn't quite fit the current mood that I'm in, that I'm looking for, but still a good movie. Mother, with an exclamation point at the end, 2017. Great. great movie doesn't quite fit the, for me, the type of atmospheric movie I'm looking for. It has some moments that are somewhat atmospheric or quiet, so to speak, but it's still a good movie. Very, it's, I don't want to spoil anything, but it's based on something. I don't know how to describe it. It's apparently, a modern, unique take on an old, story, we'll say. Yeah, I don't want to spoil anything. You just have to watch it. Okay. I also just watched, and I think this was this Saturday morning, prior to this video, Andrei Tarkovsky's 1979 film Stalker, which I think is like 3 to 4 hours long, something like it. I know I had a take, I started it at like 11:30 in the morning, took a break for lunch, and then I didn't finish it till like 3 o'clock, something like that. So I'm pretty sure it's 3 to 4 hours long. Fantastic movie, has all the elements that I like in it, pretty much. There's no real special effects, anything surreal, but what they talk about, the different metaphors, and the ending is kind of interesting. But that's a great film. So I finally saw it. So thank you for that suggestion. The 1973 movie, the original Wicker Man, just saw that as well. I think I was that Saturday or Sunday, it doesn't really matter. Fantastic. It starts off kind of like a normal movie. Some music, and there's someone in the plane, and overhead view of the land, and then a couple minutes later, when the plane lands, and you start to get on the location where they are, things get weird. Really quick, it doesn't take long, like 5 minutes into the movie, and you just get past what you think is going to be like a very simple, plain, normal type of movie, and it just starts to get weird, and an ending, I kind of saw it coming a little bit towards the end. But a great, great ending, great twist. And it's from 1973, so 50 years ago. But it still holds up. Some movies are quite dated. Some movies from the 80s. But some of these other movies, I don't know why they're so old. Like Stalker and The Wicker Man, they're so old. But yet, it's almost as if they were made today to seem old. So they're somewhat timeless, I think. Great movies. Next was Hagazusa. I'm not sure how you pronounce that. Somewhat like The Witch. Story of isolation. Some apparent witches. That was okay. It was good. But something about it was just not quite, I like the atmosphere of it and everything, the way it was filmed, but there was just something about it that was just a little off from me really enjoying it. Can't really put my finger on it. A good movie, good enough. Like, I mean, that's not why I watch these movies. I watch them just for to watch a unique movie, for this atmospheric type of sound design, for the minimal dialogue. And honestly, I don't really care what the movie is about, you know, and all that. So, but Hagazusa, however you, it's probably not how you even pronounce it. It's in a different language. And I'm not sure if it's Norse, Swedish, whatever. But yeah, that's just, my vocabulary is limited. I keep saying great over and over again, but just, it was a great movie, but something about it, I just was not quite fully thrilled with it. Okay. The next movie, The Night House. This movie seemed to have a little bit of a higher production value. Seemed to be like a normal horror movie made today, where it's not, and what I mean by that, it's very clean. Like it's a, there's no grain. It's to the film, there's no film grain. It's not, it's just, yeah, I don't know how to put it. It's almost like trying to be very perfect in how it's filmed with, you know, high budget cameras and all that, special effects somewhat, which, no, which is fine. So, but I just prefer the more grainy, somewhat lower budget, lo-fi movies. You know, for the most part. But anyway, The Night House was a good kind of scary horror thriller. With, kind of a different, unique kind of story ending, ghost story type of movie. Some jump scares. So, not bad, not quite my cup of tea, but no, not too bad of a movie. Melancholia. This is somewhat of a sci-fi, not horror, more drama. A good movie. A very unique ending, a satisfying ending. I like the way it ended. You don't really get to see that type of ending. Usually everybody likes happy endings. I don't want to give anything, well, I kind of spoiled things, I guess. But that movie, not quite my cup of tea. A little bit too drama, a little bit too long, but still a good movie. Different, you know, I enjoyed it. It Follows. Fantastic. Love it. Love it as much as I love Alien and Skinamarink and Enos Men. One of my favorites. I saw It Follows. I'm subscribed to Amazon Prime. I don't think you can find these on Netflix. I remember a long time ago, Netflix, you could rent all these types of movies through the mail on a DVD. But now Netflix doesn't, I don't really think you can find these movies on Netflix. Anyway, enough about Netflix. So I saw It Follows being suggested, or just being there when scrolling through the list of horror movies to watch on Amazon, and I saw something about a sexual encounter, and I'm like, kind of turned me off. I was being a little judgmental. I don't like to watch movies where there's a lot of gratuitous sex and violence, so that turned me off, but I see it. It had a ton of good reviews. Some of you suggested it, so I finally bit the bullet, and I'm glad I did. I hate when I get judgmental like that, and I won't watch something because of the blurb or the poster, and not all the time. I'm not judgmental like that all the time. I'm much more open-minded to watch anything, but I am picky and moody, temperamental, so I have to be in the right mood. Anyway, It Follows was great. Kind of like a new take on an 80s movie, so to speak. I think it was somewhat based in the 80s, something like that. Yeah, that was a great movie, great beginning, great ending, somewhat. And all throughout, not quite the atmospheric horror movie like Skinamarink or Ennis Men, right? It's, which I don't think it's supposed to be, but it's still a great movie anyway. Next, I just watched before this video, I think it was the Saturday before, Tetsuo the Iron Man. This is like a David Lynch movie on acid. Completely bonkers. Great movie. Horror. Body horror. I don't mind some body horror and some gore. No gore, really. More body horror involving a drill and a snaking pipe. Couple of scenes in there I wasn't expecting. And it starts off one way and then ends somewhat completely different, a little bit almost comical. Some, you might say, there are some comical scenes in it, just at how absurd it is. But yeah, just a great movie. I could watch it again, kind of. Yeah, but the scene with the drill, it's like comedy and horror, but without trying to be funny. Just absurd. So great movie. And some stop motion in it as well. Speaking of stop motion, I saw Mad God for the first time. Bunch of folks recommended that. That's another movie. Did you hear that? Okay. You didn't hear anything again? Okay. That's probably nothing. Anyway. So, Mad God, I saw that kind of suggested, recommended, when scrolling through on Amazon. I think I saw it on there for the past year. But for some reason, just wasn't in the mood to watch a stop animation, or just in the mood in general. But I'm so glad I watched it. That is just one of those movies you watch 2, 3, 4 times to see all the different things that happen in it. Somewhat, yeah, it's somewhat of a similar premise or story like Mother with the exclamation point. General theme, overall theme, so to speak. I don't want to ruin anything, but amazing stop motion. Just so much detail and things going on, and somewhat existential, philosophical in a way. So, love it. Mad Guy was fantastic. So, next is We're All Going to the World's Fair. I thought it was a really good movie. Pretty great. Not quite my cup of tea, a little bit. Nothing against the actors. I thought the actors put on great performances, especially the female lead. I think it was her debut performance. Some questions about the ending and somewhat the plot, but I don't like to nitpick too much, so it was a good movie. Not quite my cup of tea. But a good movie nonetheless. Next is Creep, which came out like 2011, I think. A lot of these movies, I don't know how I miss them. It's funny. Somehow they go right under the radar. And of course, you know, you might not be in the mood for a movie for a month, for a few months, for a whole year. Right? Creep, not quite the atmospheric type of minimal dialogue movie. It's kind of like a found footage, somewhat. It's not found footage, but somewhat low budget, for sure. A great movie. Unique ending, for sure. Wasn't expecting it. A good movie. Definitely a great movie, but just not quite my cup of tea in regards to the relaxing, long scenes and shots, and you just hear crickets or someone walking on gravel. Not quite that type of movie, but still good. The Banshees of Inisherin. This is based in Ireland, I think, somewhat during the NRA conflicts, which I'm not sure if they're still going on or what. Not a horror movie, more of a comedy and drama with, you might say, a little bit of body horror. But quite interesting. So a little bit of, a teeny tiny bit of horror element, but it's primarily a comedy drama, I think. It does have some of the elements that I like, but it is more dialogue heavy. It's more of a typical movie. I think it's an indie movie, but it's more of a mainstream indie movie, I think, than an obscure movie. Not really horror at all, but still a good movie to watch. I liked it, but just not quite my cup of tea in regards to the atmospheric psychological horror. So those are all the movies I've seen a few days leading up to this video. So, love them for the most part. But Skinamarink, Ennis Men, Possum, A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night, 1979, Stalker, Hagazusa, I would say somewhat We're All Going to the World's Fair, somewhat. Those are the movies that that have the elements that I like. The rest of them are great, but just like I said, not quite my cup of tea. Okay, now I'm going to talk about a bunch of movies. Well, I'm not going to spend the next half hour, but I'm going to kind of run through the titles, talk briefly about them. Alright, so some of the movies that were suggested by some folks who commented on that post I made on my channel, on the community tab on my channel. And these are all movies that I've seen, like, a year ago, 2 years ago, and further back. So, Border, 2018, Swedish film, very unique type of story, loved it, saw that a couple years ago. The Wailing, 2016, South Korean horror film, with a bit of folklore to it, loved it, saw that like 2 or 3 years ago. Naked Lunch, a surreal science fiction film based on the book by William S. Burroughs and directed by David Cronenberg. I did see that 10 years ago or something. Barbarian, 2022. I thought that was good. I had a little question about some of the quote-unquote people, the antagonists in the movie, and how they exist, stuff like this. But it was a pretty good movie. I wouldn't watch it again. But yeah, it was good. I liked it for the most part. The Machinist with Christian Bale. I saw that like 10 years ago. I loved it. I'd have to watch that again. The Ring from 2012. Isn't that when the girl comes out of the TV? The Well. I forget. I think I saw that again. I mean, it came out in 2002, so probably saw it like 10 years ago. I'd have to watch it again. The Witch, 2015, by Robert Eggers. I did see that. That was one of the... I saw that probably around 2015, 2016, 17. Yeah, definitely the type of movie that I like from what I remember. Minimal dialogue, a lot of quiet scenes, building up a sense of terror, suspense, right? From what I can recall. A very interesting ending that kind of why it's called The Witch. And I think when I saw that, it was a type of movie where I was like, I want to see more of this, but it's kind of hard to find. Just kind of hard to find these atmospheric movies. Let the Right One In, 2008. Another minimal dialogue type of movie. Long, drawn out scenes, from what I recall. Loved it. It's the Swedish original version of the book. Let Me In, I think is the book's name. By John Lindqvist, Swedish author. The Lighthouse, I did see that. A lot of folks suggested that I saw that. I'm not sure the same year it came out. I just remember seeing it pop up on Netflix or Amazon Prime, I forget which. Didn't see it in the theater. With Willem Dafoe, and I forget who the other actor is. Great movie. From what I know, it's some heavy dialogue. Some points. I can't have to watch it again to see if it's the type of movie that I like. I think it is. I remember watching it once and loving it. So maybe it does fit type of movie I like. The Void. I saw that about a year or two ago. But it came out in 2015. I didn't see it when it came out. It's a Lovecraftian movie. Involves a police officer, some cultists, and some cool effects. Some monsters. I have to watch that again too. That was really good. I loved it. Eraserhead by David Lynch. I don't know what to say about that. Surreal. I think from what I recall, that kind of fits what I like. I mean, I love it. It's been like 10 years since I watched it. Lamb. Very unique story. I think kind of an interesting, satisfying ending involving sheep and one particular goat. I won't spoil anything. I think that was distributed by A24 Studios. And A24, they don't make films. They'll buy films that they like, I guess, and then distribute them so that we can watch them. They will produce their own movies from time to time, but they're mostly a distributor. And almost any A24 distributed movie that comes out, I'll watch in the horror genre. So Lamb, Hereditary, which I saw and I loved, which I also think is by A24. The Black Goat's Daughter, loved it. I think that's the type of movie that I also like by A24 as well. Midsommar, Midsommar, which starts off in America and then goes to Sweden, I think. Midsommar, however you pronounce it. And also an A24 movie, I think. It's very similar to The Wicker Man, the original Wicker Man. Same type of folklore traditions to it. Somewhat of a modern Wicker Man, you might say. I think the ending of Midsommar is somewhat very similar to the ending of The Wicker Man, if I'm not mistaken. Now, I'm not sure if that's because Midsommar is supposed to be a modern day Wicker Man, a retelling of The Wicker Man, or just a somewhat similar, inspired by, I don't really know, I didn't do any research. Sometimes you look into, you find a movie that was inspired by another movie, or is a retelling of another movie, so, but it might not be, but they're quite similar, if I'm not mistaken. Midsommar and The Wicker Man. Next we have 2001, A Space Odyssey. From 1968. I remember seeing that as a kid and just being totally confused. It is very atmospheric, minimal dialogue. There's music throughout, but the music is okay. Some of the greatest music ever, obviously. And it does have a little bit of a horror element to it. You could say mostly science fiction with a little dash of horror. Donnie Darko, I saw that like 15 years ago, a long time ago. Don't remember much about it except maybe a rabbit, something like that, a dark rabbit. Yeah, I have to watch that again. The Babadook, I thought that was okay. I'm not quite sure if that's my cup of tea. I watched it once. It doesn't really make me feel like I want to watch it again. It's one of my favorites, like A24 films. Maybe it was put out by A24, I don't know. Primal, it's an animated series. I think it's animated by a Russian animator, director, something like that. I did see the first series. It's available on Amazon, I think. I saw the first series. It was recommended to a viewer on one of my videos like 2 years ago. I haven't watched the second part of it. A Quiet Place. That was somewhat of a not quite my cup of tea in regards to the atmospheric movies that I like. A good movie. Just one part I didn't like about it involving a nail and stairs. So, alright. But a good movie. You know, aside from that, Phantasm. Boy, I saw that in the 80s. That's like 40 years ago. I probably should watch it again. I don't know if it fits the atmospheric, psychological horror that I like. It's a classic horror film, so I should rewatch it. And then Cube from 1997. A bunch of people are trapped in this weird maze, and I loved it. Very unique premise and story. I don't think anything's ever been done like it. So I love it. I don't know it though. If it fits the whole atmospheric thing, I think it's somewhat a lot of dialogue, a lot of action and moving scenes. So, still a good movie. I think I forgot to mention. I said The Void, which was Lovecraftian. There's also The Endless, which has Lovecraftian influences. The Endless, that was a great movie. I think the directors of The Endless did another movie with some investigators. If I'm not mistaken, police investigators get involved in some weird stuff as well. But anyway, The Endless, that was good. Somewhat of a story involving a cult, so to speak, and time loops. Very different. Yeah, I like that. Okay, now for the list of movies I haven't seen, which are on my bucket list. And I'm just going to read these off. And again, I don't know. I was just doing some research online, trying to find movies similar to Skinamarink, Ennis Men, Possum, etc. And I found at different sources with different recommendations. So these may or may not be my cup of tea, but I want to see them regardless, because I just want to see new things. I just need that. I want to see some films here that might be some hidden gems. The Vigil, 2021. Darling, 2015. Dumbbad, Dumbbad, 2018. November, 2017. The Hunger, 1983. The Man Who Fell to Earth, 1976. Tideland, 2005. Paper House, 1988. The Sailor Who Fell from Grace with the Sea. Don't Look Now, 1973. Cold Skin, 2017. I did watch the trailer for Cold Skin. It seems to be somewhat of a sci-fi action and horror. Maybe not even horror, I don't know. Not quite atmospheric. At least based on the trailer. Sometimes these trailers put a lot of the action sequences together. But who knows, I'm gonna give it a try anyway. Climax, Through a Glass Darkly, 1961. Without Name, 2016. Violent, 2014. Evolution, 2015. Enter the Void, 2009. Men, 2022. Antichrist, 2009. Monument, 2018. I Am the Pretty Thing That Lives in the House. The Guest, Athena, Dead of Night, 1945, a field in England. Don't look now. The amusement park. What Josiah saw, 2021. Amulet, 2020. Proxy, 2013. Attachment, 2022. Lamb, 2021. Oh, I think I mentioned Lamb. Yeah, I did. That's an A24 film. Dark Was the Night. A Cure for Wellness. Apostle. The Skeleton Key. In the Tall Grass. She Will. Session 9, 2001. Pulse, 2001. And Cure. Both by the same director. I think a Japanese, Kiyoshi Kurosawa. Memoria. I think Memoria is a war film. So not horror. It might have the same elements that I like. The atmosphere. The pace. But I'm not really into war films that much. But I'll try to check it out. Pandorum. 3. The Ritual. It's like the Roman numeral 3, III, hyphen The Ritual, I think, is, I think there's also The Ritual, the movie, so, but I think this is 3, The Ritual, or 3, Ritual, whatever, and then November, St. Maud, The Earth, Under the Skin, Rax, 2009, We Have Always Lived in the Castle, 2018, Solaris, another film by Andrei Tarkovsky, who did Stalker, The Cold Skin, Amer, A-M-E-R, Strange Color, A Ghost Story, and again, I don't really know if all these movies are my cup of tea or not, but we'll see. The Outwaters, My Dinner with Andre. I started to watch this very heavy dialogue. It's kind of lo-fi, but not quite my cup of tea right now. But I've heard about it, and I do need to watch it at some point. But just right now, I'm just not in the mood for that type of movie. But thanks for the suggestion. Mandy, 2018. House, from 1977. Koyaanisqatsi, which is a documentary by Francis Ford Coppola, I think, if I'm not mistaken. So I'm kind of on the fence about that one. The Northman. A Viking, I think it's a Viking type of movie. Man Versus, Picnic at Hanging Rock, Walkabout, The Last Wave, The Eyes of My Mother, Valhalla Rising, Antrim from the 70s, The Invitation, 2016, Inland Empire, which is by David Lynch, which I'm surprised I haven't seen. Nightcrawler. Come True, 2020. Cracks, 2009. Nope. Lake Mungo. A Ghost Story. Same director as The Green Knight. And I did see The Green Knight about 2 years ago. And from what I recall, I enjoyed that. Not sure if it was like a favorite of mine. I can't recall. Censor. A Field in England. Did I just say that? Apostle. In the Earth. Noroi. The Curse. Japanese horror, I think. The Menu. Flux. Gourmet. Infinity Pool. Benda's Fen. Witchfinder General. The Headhunter. A low-budget medieval horror. Yamishibai. Junji Ito, Maniac, Japanese Tales of the Macabre, Junji Ito is the author, illustrator behind a bunch of popular horror manga, such as Uzumaki and Tomie, the Swedish film Seventh Seal. I think I saw the American version of Seventh Seal. I remember seeing Seventh Seal, but there are American actors in the 80s, so maybe this is a different version or whatever, different type of movie altogether, I don't know. Something in the Dirt, Moon Garden, In the Earth, Possessor, Saint Maud, Under the Skin, Beyond the Black Rainbow, The Innocents, 1961, The Empty Man, The Atwaters, Resurrection, from 2022, I believe, Anything for Jackson, You Won't Be Alone, 2022, I think it's a folklore horror, The Hands of Fate, The Vast of Night, and The Ritual, 2017. So there is The Ritual. Then we also had Three, The Ritual, unless they're the same, I don't know. Alright, well, that's gonna do it. So, thank you very much for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed all these, maybe some movies that you might be familiar with. Maybe some you haven't heard before. So, maybe you'll be inclined to check them out at some point. You know, don't watch anything because I recommend it. You know, you should always just be open-minded and watch something because looks intriguing and interesting, not because anyone says you should or shouldn't. Somebody says you should watch something, you might not like it. Someone says you shouldn't, you might like it. So you just gotta be open, have an open mind and be receptive, you know, to watching something, and all, you know, when you want to and when you're in the mood, like me, like I'm in the mood right now, not for video games, not for any drama documentaries, but for these atmospheric horror films that no gore, no people suffering or torture. I don't like any of that stuff, like Hostel. I don't like that stuff, so, and that's gonna do it for me. So, stay safe, stay well, and I hope to see you.